Hey, polished people, what's going on? It's your girl, the Polished Lady, and I am here with a very special guest, my girl Shak.
Hello.
Hey, how are you doing today?
I'm great.
All right, and before we get into this interview, I definitely would please ask you guys to subscribe to that little red button over there and make sure you turn on your notification bell so you can get more of these interviews coming soon. It's all good. Okay, so
now we ready.
Yes, we're ready. The wine's here. We're winding down. It's not Wednesday, but it's all sip sip.
Yeah, it's a good day for a wind down. Self love.
Right. That is what we're here to talk about, is self love. So first, can you tell us a little bit about yourself and why you decided to start Rebundle?
Okay. So I'm Shak. About me, I'm a mother of two. 31.
She's fabulous.
Thank you.
Yes,
work in finance. That's my 9-to-5. And Rebundle really just started out of it's like a heart project is what I like to describe it as, because it really just came from a place of all my own insecurities and all the things that, you know, when I, the role models I would want to have or I didn't have or that I found. So it's just a bundle of experiences and a way of me to give that back to the girl who can relate to maybe my story or any of my testimonies, anything that I've been through. And it was just like, man, you know what? If I could do something, I would want to be that person for that girl that I was or who I would want to have looked up to. So just embedding myself and learning how to be a woman, learning how to be a queen and to really honor myself and respect myself and set boundaries, it really just shaped and formed this program, and it turned into this organization of Rebundle from what I already did was talking to women naturally, you know, about these things, whether it was me getting advice, giving advice, just having conversations. It's what we do as a unit, as a village, as women. It's just kind of what we do. So it's just my way to, you know, really promote that and empower us to be great and love ourselves and do what it is that we feel we're here to do.
Right. And so can you tell us about what led you to that moment to say, I have to start this? And then not only I have to start this for to self-love myself, but and then teach it to other women.
So that's a good question. It is, because it's so many times that, you know, like going through life, I'm a real woman. I'm a single mother, so I've had, you know, multiple journeys. I've been in multiple roles in life. So it's always a point where to say, like, when was that moment? It's so many moments where it was like, I gotta do this. I have a daughter. So I think one of the biggest moments that led me to talk and really teach this was her dealing with her navigating the self-image and her own confidence and wanting and remembering who I was as that little girl and going through that phase. And so through her little issues at school, I decided to be like, hey, look, I have a program that I'm working on. I'll do this for little girls. So that was really the moment of me like, I gotta teach this, because it's so important as young girls that we learn to respect each other, love each other, but first we gotta understand how to do that for ourselves and stand in our own power and our own confidence, because that influences how others see you. And if people see you as timid, or they see you as weak, or they see you insecure, they're
going
to be attracted to that. You know, they're going to be attracted. It's just, it's part of human nature. But when they see you as a confident person, they see you, you know, it kind of throws them off, and it makes them want to be more like you, want to understand you. And it just opens things up for a better environment for people to grow and connect. So I think that it's important on both the inside and the outside, is really learning to refine and define your confidence, because it's really a matter of who you see yourself as versus who everyone else wants you to be or has told you who you are. So learning, just being able to bring that to an elementary level of girls, I was like, okay, if I could do this, and they loved it, we had a great time, I really feel like it really, it mattered to them. They were asking for it for, you know, multiple times after that to get it started, which I had to do again.
Mm-hmm.
But it really made a difference in how they interacted with one another, especially as young girls of color, little black girls, you know, little brown girls, minority girls, because there's a reason why it's called a minority. It's already a, you know, that term alone already kind of puts
diminishes
a ceiling.
A
yeah. So to kind of break that, just to see how you see yourself as without those labels and just who you are. That's what Rebundle is really, really about, is getting you to really shed all your labels, all your fears, and really accept and develop who you are. You know, that royal part of you.
So. I love that. So you hit on a key point when you were talking about how little girls, little black girls, see themselves. And I know that I had a pen pal program at one point with another elementary school. And I noticed that when we came into their environment, they were like, you're seeing me for the first time. And it's like, you actually want to be here for me. It's not just like, I'm just a phase in your life. How do we go from that tiny age and then growing up our age, you know what I'm saying? And how do we say, okay, I want somebody else to see me or see the next woman and really appreciate her?
Yeah.
How do we lift one another up?
At all, going through life only makes you better. It doesn't change who you are.
I feel like she's preaching to me. I feel touched. Okay, I needed this message. I don't know about y'all, but I hope y'all listening.
Yeah, so that's what we, you know, that's what I want to give. And by doing that, it gives to me. By doing this, you know, as I go through my journey and I continue to grow and develop, it feeds me, and I'm teaching myself by having to learn these things and do the work and do the research and self-reflect a lot. Like, what's okay, self-check. Let me check myself. Let me see why I'm feeling these emotions. Let me break this down. Let me know what this means. It takes a lot of depth. It's deep, but you can do it, and it's baby steps. You don't have to do it all at once.
So, before, you know, we dive into our food, I just want to ask you, what is a part of your self-love routine?
Okay. My self-love routine, working out, fitness, that's a big part of it. Even if just stretching, just really connecting myself with my body and allowing myself to really feel my own energy. That's what I really like about fitness. I love eating, so if I get a chance to
me
dine,
too, girl. Mm-hmm.
I do that for myself. I don't restrict myself by the thought of lack or limiting or feeling like, well, I gotta get more. No, I first put myself as number one. So really my self-love is to do what makes me feel good that day. You know, within me. I'm not crazy.
Right.
But to do what I feel is good. And if I feel like I want to lay down in bed and just relax, that's what I do that day. Because I know that I'm taking care of everything else. I'm doing what I'm supposed to do. And I deserve that. That's self-love. So taking a rose bath, that's like my, I have to do that once a week.
Okay. I've never tried that.
Oh my gosh. Rose bath.
I had fake yellow flowers. They were roses.
No, get you some, just get you some real ones. And you can let them sit for a while. Let them, you know, blossom. And when they're, before they are like dead, just pick them off and shake them in your bath. And it just relaxes you. Just really relaxing. Candles, lighting candles, and just really music. So those are some ways that I really just take time for me. That's what a lot of my self-love is being able to take that time to connect with me, because it helps me to really remember, you know, what I want out of this. Like, what am I doing everything that I do for? You know, I'm not working just to make money, or I'm not out here just helping people just to be liked. Like, what? Why am I just connecting with yourself again? I think it just re-energizes you, you know, because we have to recharge. And it gives you time to really dig deeper in your vision. So, sleeping can be productive.
You know?
It's your beauty mess.
Get some sleep. Yes. Should I? All right, y'all. We about to eat. I told you guys we'd be back after we were done eating. This is a first of many. I like this, you know, the scenic route and dining with my sister here. I don't have no complaints right now. This is a good day. This is a great start to my day. I don't know. Nice little pickup. Yes. So let's get back into this interview. Let's talk about what is a common mistake that we make when we're supposed to be showing ourselves self-love or practicing our self-care routine. What's a common mistake that you see?
I would say probably just forgetting that that's what we're doing, putting other people before us, being distracted. You have to, like, just like going to work, you have to discipline yourself for your me time. Gotta make it a priority. Like, no, kids knock at the door, go away. If it's not life or death right now, go away. This is my time. And it's okay. Like, I think
and that's really hard as a mom. Yeah, because I'd be like,
feel guilty.
Oh, yeah, because I'd be like, oh, baby, I'm sorry. Mommy's sorry. What you say? What you need?
Yeah.
You said chocolate milk?
Yeah, so I would say, like, the guilt trip. We start feeling guilty. Because it's our kids, or, you know, it's work, or whatever it is, we are a priority just like everything else. So that is probably the biggest mistake with self-love. You gotta be like, no, check your own self. No, this is my time. I'm gonna dedicate it to me and me only. I'm gonna do whatever it is in this moment. If it's your yoga time, do your yoga time. If it's your, you know, your meditation or your bath time, just take care of that. If it's your nap time, take your nap. Do what it is that you need to do for you, because it's important. It's really, really important. Like, it's important to everything else. Once you have that time to just relax and renew yourself, you can do everything else so much more easier, you know.
I believe in that. Well, I'm trying to think. I do feel guilty. I noticed that something about myself is I always say, I'm sorry. And I be like, I'm not really sorry about it. I just feel like I inconvenienced you in a way. But really, maybe I haven't been conditioned that way.
Yeah.
That's crazy.
Yeah, a lot of times we say sorry.
Discovery happening right here.
Yeah, I've done that and had to correct myself with even doing that, like just saying I'm sorry. Like, no, I'm not sorry. So I watch the things that I say I'm sorry for, because it's not, you don't need to be sorry for everything. If this is how I feel, and I'm, you know, and you feel inconvenienced or you feel a certain way about it, well, it's not really for me to fix how you feel, because I also feel a certain way. That's why I'm doing what I'm doing, because this is my boundary. You know, and it's okay for you to feel a way, you to feel different from how I feel or not agree. It's okay. I think that's where sometimes we get lost with it, is that we want everyone to feel like, you know, okay, everybody's on the same page. It's okay. No, you can't. That's not, we can't be. But we can come to an understanding if you're okay with how you feel and I'm okay with how I feel, and we can communicate that. It's okay. So you have to, you know, don't be sorry for who you are or be sorry for how you feel. Seek more to just understand and have others to understand why you feel that way. You know, it's not so personal. It's not an attack. And I think that's why we're always like, I'm sorry, because I don't want to attack you. I don't want to hurt you, but you're not attacking them.
It's
just
not personal. It's not, girl. You trying to make me cry?
No.
I'm finna cry.
Don't
she preaching to me. She preaching to me. Sis preaching to me. Oh, Jesus. Hallelujah.
If you need to, you can though.
I ain't gonna cry. I'm not gonna cry. No, now it's not the time. In the words of Mary. She done got me good.
It's real though. You know, it's a journey. I'm telling you, it's an emotional roller coaster. It's a journey, because anything, you know, when you open yourself up to learn about you, you know, not about just to learn you. It brings out emotional. I got emotional at a point where I was just like, this is not even me. Like, I'm not this emotional. And I was like super duper sensitive to the weirdest stuff, you know, but it was me breaking down walls within myself, because I was discovering me. And it just takes time to get okay with that, you know, to really get through that just a little bit at a time. So, and anything can kind of take you there. But that's just part of it. You learning yourself.
Yeah, the triggers, man.
Yeah.
These triggers, that is a real thing.
Yes.
That is a real thing. So let's get into the happy. Let's get into some happy, girl. What does the future of Rebundle look like for you? What is
amazing.
In store? Amen?
Yes, amazing. The future of Rebundle, the end picture, it's a humongous vision, you know, that I have to be like, really? I'm going to, okay. Yeah, I trust it. But the near future is the launch, the official launch of Rebundle around June 2021. In between that, just really getting out, talking to different groups, talking to different people, connecting with different women. We'll be doing our women discussion events, the Pink Matters will be coming back, so getting a couple of those in there. And really getting all the work done for the courses that the members will be able to receive. So it's going to be a lot of fun, a lot of love, a lot of roses, lots of crowns, just good energy. So we'll see. Whatever else God wants in this plan.
How can people reach out to you and book your services?
You can reach out on Instagram, Rebundle2K17. We also have the website, www.rebundle.org. You can reach out there. Also on Facebook, Rebundle as well. So you can definitely connect with us on social media. We'll be having a lot more information coming out and sharing a lot more as we continue to develop and to get everything in place, because I'm like, you know, perfectionist, so that's something I'm working on. It's not trying to make everything perfect, but it will be, because it's for us, so, you know, it has to be great. It has to be magical.
It's going to be great. It's going to be great. I'm putting that on your, on your vision, and we are definitely, me, myself, I need Rebundle services, girl. I need it, girl. I feel like you was just talking to me, and I just
anytime. Whoa. Yeah. Whoa. That's what I'm here for, you know. And you know, just personally and professionally, you can reach out to me anytime because I've seen you. You know, I've told you before over the years, and I love the woman that you are, that you've been, that you're becoming. It's beautiful.
She's trying to make me.
I love it.
Not going.
I love it. You know.
I see you too, sis. Y'all, make sure, do me the biggest favor, make sure that you go check out Rebundle, follow them, follow her on Instagram, follow her on Facebook, and keep updated with all the information that she's going to be putting out. That way, you know, you can get healed too. Find your own ways to self-love, you know what I'm saying? It's so hard in a society that tells us we have to be perfect at every picture, perfect moment, and it's not. You don't have to be that, and I thank you for letting me facilitate this interview. Y'all know
thank
what we had to go through to get here, but we made
but
it. Ain't God good? Hallelujah. All right, I love y'all. Stay polished. Be your greatest self. Love yourself. Amen. Bye.